cult is leaving supplies around for themselves.
Children in Bright Falls all grew up hearing stories about the cult of the tree. Feral maniacs living in the woods. Satanists chanting, "We watch in the night," as they perform blood sacrifices in the forests. Or things not quite human lurking in the dark. There were many versions of the story, but they all shared one important element. Danger in the dark, in the woods. Somewhere among all the urban legends lay a secret truth. The real identity of the cultists prowling in the woods. Real faces hid behind the masks. Real hands held the knives. Real people fulfilling a grim purpose. The forest was not safe. People were right to keep their children away from the trees.
Another one of those rhymes. A little clothespin doll. Perfect weird souvenir for Logan. Another locked box.
Back at Witch's Ladle, Saga pointed the flashlight at the strange, dark substance. The same substance Nightingale had left at the morgue. There was something hidden under it. She strained to see, the opposite of sunspots in her eyes, blacker than black. Suddenly a change. The light reacted to the substance, a feedback loop surging up her arm. Saga squeezed the flashlight, willing it to penetrate the dark matter. Burn it away. An overlap of the Dark Place needed a push from both directions to manifest itself. Reality in our world eroded by repeated dark lore tied to a location and a counterpoint. A work of art, a horror narrative crafted in the depths of the Dark Place, connecting to the story on the other side to reach out through the weakened veil. A story of a lawman whose heart was cut out of his chest. Two corrupt men killed by their own twisted ambition. A haunted old woman drowned in a bathtub. Twisted reflections on the other side of the mirror. Arcs stabbing through realities, amplifying the influence of the Dark Place. These elements working in conjunction made a trickle that became a torrent, a wormhole, a vortex, and the art, the map, became the nightmare territory where the Dark Place encroached on our reality, a blanket over it, where they all overlapped, causing reality to twist and loop like a bad dream, remolding anything and anyone within its dark horror design.
Another one of those lunchboxes. There's a rhyme over here. I feel bad for these guys.
reached the car, Anderson. How's it going down there?
I think I'm done here. I'll meet you at the parking lot. Another Alex Casey lunchbox? I need to go back. Got a case to solve. Doesn't look right. The FBC is definitely playing with things they don't fully understand. And that always goes well.
I need bolt cutters.